हेलो माय लवली फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू टुडे? इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट प्रोसेसर टेक्नोलॉजी। वी कैन डिफाइन टेक्नोलॉजी एज ए मैनर ऑफ एकॉम्प्लिशिंग ए टास्क, स्पेशली यूजिंग टेक्निकल प्रोसेस, मेथड और नॉलेज। प्रोसेसर टेक्नोलॉजी रिलेट्स टू द आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ कंप्यूटेशन इंजन यूज टू इम्प्लीमेंट ए सिस्टम्स डिजायर्ड फंक्शनैलिटी। ऑल्दो the term processor is usually associated with programmable software processors, we can think of many other non-programmable digital circuits as a processors also. Each such processors differs in its specialization towards a particular function, for example image compression. Thus manifesting design matrices differ from other processors. I want to illustrate this concept graphically. The application requires a specific embedded functionality symbolized as a cross, you can see in the figure, such as the summing of the items in an array. How can we add? Firstly, we can count it 0, then for loop I equals to 1 up to n, we will sum all the numbers, and after reaching to the nth value, the loop will end. So we use a collection of such processor to optimize a system's design matrices, as in our digital camera example which I explained in first lecture. So what is general purpose processor software? The designer of a general purpose processor or microprocessor builds a programmable device that is suitable for a variety of applications to maximize the number of devices to be sold. One feature of such a processor is a program memory. The designer of such a processor does not know what program will run on the processor, so the program cannot be built into digital circuit. Another feature is a general data path. The data path must be general enough to handle a variety of computation. So such a path, data path, typically has a large register file and one or more general purpose arithmetic logic unit, that is ALU. An embedded system designer, however, need not be concerned about the design of general purpose processor. An embedded system designer simplify uses a general purpose processor by programming the processor's memory to carry out the required functionality. Many people refers to this part of an implementation as a software portion. Using a general purpose processor in an embedded system may result in several design metric benefit. Time to market and the NRE cost are low because the designer must only write a program but not do any digital design. Flexibility is high because changing functionality requires changing only the program. Unit cost may be low in a small quantity compared with designing our own processor. Since general purpose processor manufacturer sells large quantity to other customer and hence distribute the NRE cost over many units, performance may be fast for computation intensive application if using a fast processor due to advanced architecture feature and leading edge IC technology. However, there are also some design metrics drawback. Unit cost may be relatively high for large quantities, since in large quantity we could design our own processor and optimize our NRI cost such that our unit cost is lower. Performance may be slow for certain application, size and power may be large due to unnecessary processor hardware. For example, we can use general purpose processor to carry out our arrays summing functionality. From illustrate that a general purpose processor covers the desired functionality but not necessarily efficiently. This figure A shows a simple architecture of a general purpose processor implementing these array summing functionality. The functionality is stored in a program memory. The controller fetches the current instruction as indicated by the program controller, that is PC, into the instruction register IR, and it then configures the data path for its instruction and executes the instruction. It then determines the next instruction address, sets the PC to this, and fetches it again. When we come upon a single purpose processor, that is for hardware, a single purpose processor is a digital circuit designed to execute exactly one program. For example, consider the digital camera, which I had shown in my first lecture. All of the components other than microcontroller are single purpose processor. For example, the JPEG codec execute a single program that compresses and decompresses video frames. An embedded system designer may create a single purpose processor by designing a custom digital circuit. Alternately, the designer may purchase a pre-designed single purpose processor. Many people refer to this part of implementation simply as hardware portion. Although even software requires a hardware processor on which to run the program. Other common terms include coprocessor, escalator, and peripherals. Using a single purpose processor in an embedded system result in several design metric benefit and drawbacks, which are essentially the inverse of those for general purpose processor. Performance may be fast, size and power may be small, and unit cost may be low for large quantity, while design time and NRE cost may be high, flexibility low, unit cost high for some quantities, and performance may not match general purpose processor for some application. The figure C illustrates the architecture of such a single purpose processor. For example, the data path contains only the essential components for this specific program. Since the processor only executes this one program, we hardwire the program instructions directly into the control logic and use a state register to step through those instructions, so no program memory is necessary. So coming up on application specific processor and application specific instruction set processor, ASIP, can serve as a compromise between the other processor option. An ASIP is a programmable processor optimized for particular class of application having common characteristics such as embedded control, digital signal processing, or in telecommunication. The designer of such a processor can optimize the data path for the application class, perhaps adding a special functional unit for common operation and eliminating other infrequently used units. Using an ASIP in an embedded system can provide the benefit of flexibility while still achieving good performance, power, and size. However, such processor can require large NRE cost to build the processor itself and to build a compiler. If these items do not already exist, much research currently focuses on automatically generated application specific processor and their associated compile and debug environment. However, due to the lack of good compilers that can exploit the unique feature of most ASIP, designers using ASIP often write much of the software in the assembly language. Microcontrollers and digital signal processors are two well-known types of ASIP that have been used for several decades. A microprocessor is a microprocessor that has been optimized for embedded control application. Such application typically monitors and set numerous single bit control signals but do not perform large amount of data computation. Thus, microcontrollers tends to have simple data paths that excel at bit level operation and at reading and writing external bit. Furthermore, they tends to incorporate on the microprocessor chip several peripherals components common in control application like serial communication peripherals, timers, counter, pulse width modulators, and analog digital converters. Such incorporation of peripherals enables single chip implementation and hence a smaller and lower cost products. Now talking about DSPs, digital signal processor are another common type of ASIP. A DSP is a microprocessor designed to perform common operation on digital signal, which are the digital encoding of analog signal like video and audio. These operations carry out common signal processing tasks like signal filtering, transformation, or a combination. Such operations are usually math intensive, including operations like multiply and add or shift and add. Although microcontrollers and DSP represent widely used types of ASIPs, coming up on the first slide, the A figure shows the desired functionality. B figure shows the general purpose processors, and this C will is showing application specific processor, and this D is showing single purpose processors. So hope you can understand this thing, that general purpose processor have a wide type of application. It can be used anywhere, and as we can see from this cross sign, that if you have to perform such type of task, the best suited is single purpose processor, but it can use the general purpose processors and application specific processors. The cost and the cost will increase while using general purpose processor, but other things may be improved in future by using general purpose processor and application specific processors. Hope you have understood the whole concept. If you are watching till now, then please press the like button, and if you are new to this channel, please subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching.